Hello, fellow viewers. Now, welcome back again. My name is Sammy, or you can call me Sir Samuel. I hope you are enjoying at home. Don't forget to take your book, your pen, your pencils, and erasers. Very good, as you follow me. But don't forget to like, share, and then hit the notification bell so that in case our new video comes, you'll be able to be notified. Very good. Now this is for basic six. This is class. So we are doing science. We are having science right now, and this is for basic six. We are going to talk about materials. We are going to talk about materials. Now, when we talk about materials, what comes to your mind? When you talk about materials, what comes to your mind? You know, our environment is made up of different types of materials. Our environment is made up of what? Different types of what? Materials. Our environment is made up of what? Different materials. Very good. So these materials are used in our daily activities. These materials are used in our daily activities. Now, what are materials? A material is any substance from which things are made. A material is any substance from which things are made. So things are made from what? Materials. Things are made from what? Materials. Very good. Now, materials can be grouped in two, can be put in two groups. Materials can be put in two groups. We have metals and non-metals. So, okay, metals and non-metals. So let's take metals for today. Very good. Now, when we say metals, what comes to your mind? When we say metals, what comes to your mind? Good. You know, metals are solid materials which conduct heat and electricity. Metals are hard, solid materials which conduct heat and electricity. You know, last time in my class, I asked this question. And then people were like, oh, sir, metals are not hard, some are very solid. And someone came out and said, sir, but woods are very soft. I said, no, wood is not a metal. Metals are hard, solid materials. Hard, solid materials. Very good. Now, let's look at some of the examples of metals. Let's talk about some of the examples of what? Metals. Okay, I know you have a lot of examples in your mind right now. But trust me, I have wonderful examples over here for you. And you are going to enjoy it. Very good. Our first example is copper. Copper. I believe you've heard copper wire. Copper wire. You've heard copper wire. Copper wire. Your parents have been saying copper wire. Copper wire. Yes. Our wires are made up of copper. Yes. That is why they conduct electricity. Electricity currents can flow through them because they are good conductors of what? Electricity. That is why they are used for what? For our wires. We use it to wire our house. We use it in wiring our companies and our shops and so on and so forth. Very good. Now, the second one I'll talk about is gold. Now, we all love to see gold. We all love to hold gold. You know, gold is a metal. Gold is a metal. I have not seen some before, but I believe that it's very nice. Based on what people see, gold is a very nice, it's a very nice material that we all love to get hold of one day. Very good. Now let's talk about aluminium. Aluminium. Very good. You know, our roofing sheets are made of what? Aluminium. Our cooking utensils are made up of what? Aluminium. Our cooking utensils at home. What mommy used to cook, prepare the soup for you, prepare the bangkun and other things for you, they are made of what? Aluminium. Very good. And the last example I'll talk about is zinc. Very good. Zinc. So zinc is also a metal and it's also good for what? Heat and electricity. Bet me, never try to put a copper, gold or a zinc material in an open socket. Never try to put this kind of gadget in an open socket because they conduct heat and electricity. Now let's look at some properties of what? Some properties of metals. Let's look at some properties of metal. Properties of metal. You know, what are some of the things that when you see, you'll be able to identify that this thing is a metal. For my definition, metals are very hard. Metals are very hard. Metals are very hard. Do you understand? You can't compare wood to metal. You can't compare wood to metal. So metals are what? Very hard. Good. And then our second point on the properties of metal is metals are good conductors of heat and electricity. Metals are good conductors of heat and electricity. Very good. Metals are malleable. They are malleable, which means they can be beaten into what? Different shapes. Our cutlass wasn't like this, the metal wasn't like this, but it was beaten into that form. Our hoe we use, our parents use in the farm, that is not the shape of it, but they beaten into that shape. So metals are malleable. Do you understand? And metals are solid at room temperature. Metals are solid at what? Room temperature. And all metals are strong. All metals are very strong. Thank you so much. This ends our lesson. Let's have these activities. Let's do them. And then we shouldn't forget to send them through. We should send them through the comment section. And then we will reply you privately. Good. Explain the term metals. Explain the term metals. State four examples of metals. State four examples of metal. Very good. And then state four properties of metals. State four properties of metal. Very good. See you in our next video. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share the link. Very good. Bye-bye. God bless you.